if you go here and add to add a gear, in default setting of Blender, you can't see it here. To enable it, go here in Edit, in Preferences, and here in Add-ons, here hit Extra, and enable Extra Mesh Objects, and save Preferences. Now, if I go back here in Mesh, now we have a lot of models, and we have a gear selected. Now you can see a little window here, open it and play with this value to make your gear look as you want. Before to close this window, because if you close it, it's difficult to go back. After creating your gear, I selected and hit new. And now all what we do, we do it between this. So I go here in add, in mesh, I select mesh to volume. I connect it like this. Now I go here in add, in point, distribute points in volume, connected like this. In instance, select instance on points and make it here. Now I go here and I drag this cube here. I connect geometry to the instance just like this, and now I go here in utility, in color, I select color ramp. I connect color to scale, and I go here in utility, I select mix color. I connect mix color to the factor here, and I go here and I select texture, noise texture, right click, duplicate. I connect the first one here and second one here. I give it 1.5 and here 2 1.5. The detail, make it in 0 and select 4D. After this, you can play with this here, make it in grid, and you can play with this to make your animation as you want. Now for the animation, I go here in frame 1 and the factor, I make it in 0. Right click, insert a keyframe, and for me, I make it in 250. Now I make it in 1, right click, insert a keyframe, go back in frame 1, right click, insert a keyframe, and they go here in frame 250 and they make it in 3, right click, insert a keyframe. Now here for this one, right click, insert a keyframe, I make it in 0, And here I make it in minus 3. Right click, insert a keyframe. To make the gear with these cubes. Now, here, I go here in add, in geometry, I select join geometry and I make it here. And now I connect the input to join geometry. Now we have the gear with the cubes. To add material for this gear, go here in add, in material, select set material and connect it here. And here in material, I give it material. So here I give it material 001. Now you have a gear like this. For the materials, go back here in shader editor. As you can see, for the gear I make it in glass. Here, if I select the cubes, I make it a little metallic and I decrease the roughness and I use a color palette. Just select color ramp here, go here in add, in converter, select color ramp and connect it the base color. And here in add, in input, select object info and connect it in a random. And here you can add more or less colors to have a different colors for these cubes. Now, if I go here in geometry nodes and I select the gear. Now, if I go to my how I make it for me. Now, if you want to screen this value for me, here I make it like this and here I make it like this. To create backdrop in Blender, add a plane S and make it bigger. Go here in edit mode and select edge mode and select this one, extrude it in Z axis. Go back to object mode and go here in modifier. In generate, select bevel. Make it like this and give it some segment. Right click, shade smooth. To download the HDRI, the most popular website for this is Polyhaven. Just go here and select HDRIs. And now you have a lot of HDRI here. Choose one of this, like this, and download it. You can download it in 1K or 2K or 4K. I always download it in 4K. Download it and go here in world properties. In this yellow point, select environment texture. And now you can open the HDRI in your computer and select the folder where you are and select it. And now if I go here in viewport shading, now you can see this object is lighting by the HDRI. If you want to make the animation, just go here and select the resolution that you want and the folder where you want to be your animation, and select PNG, and after you can edit it in any video software to make it as animation. So this is the final render. I hope that you like it. I tell you goodbye and thanks for watching.